Hey guys, it's Rachel G. And I have lighting situation figured out. It looks like it's daylight in here, like I actually get sunlight in here, but really it's 10 o'clock at night in my deep dark bank basement. And I don't know what to do with my hands. I don't know, but I'm gonna just click over here. Boop! Okay. So, it's Friday, and that means it's vlog day! I don't know what I'm doing with my hands still. Okay, that's enough dancing. You guys should see my lighting setup that I just set up. It's hilarious. It's a desk light, right? Like from the Pixar, like that kind of light with a pop filter in front of it. It's fucking hilarious. You should see it. I will show it to you at the end of the video. But right now, if I just like turn the camera, it'd be all Cloverfield shaky cam, and it would be really bright. So I'll show you when the lights are. Anyway, so my lighting looks great, and it's wonderful down here. Things are getting cleaned up. I recorded a whole video on putting desks together to show you like the apparatus that you're sat on and this whole thing here. And yes, I have it printed out with a copy of the camera wheel. Bite me. Anyway, and I pulled out my computer speakers for the first time in like 3 years, and I was like, whoa, stereo sound that isn't right next to my ears? What? Revolutionary. They're not studio monitors, they're just speakers, but they're, you know, more than like 6 millimeters away from my ear, so sounds way different, dude. And I have a subwoofer. Like, what? It's crazy. but anyway, so I had some technical difficulties whilst recording that video, so you guys don't get to see it. Curse you, Logitech! But anyway, so updates. And this is the part where you realize it's really awesome that I recorded and filmed and edited the whole like episode zero. Because now you know what's going on in my life, and I can just jump right into it, and this video doesn't have to be 15 minutes long. Or does it? Who knows? Let's find out. So, I'm trying to clean up the studio. It's still freaking a wreck in here. I don't know if you guys can actually see that far that way, but there's a gigantic pile of crap, and then I have my PA system and more boxes way behind this curtain over here, and like, the only portion that's even remotely organized is, like, right here. This L shape that is made of my desks. And I guess that's kind of organized over there a little bit. Suspension. So, life updates. I talked to the promoter for my show on the 22nd. Everything should be kosher. I just have to call and double check that I have the right cables to hook into PA, because I don't know if any of RCA is a quarter inch. I'm gonna bring them both anyway, but yeah, just gotta, you know, double check. I've practiced the set list a lot more, like a lot more, and I figured out half of the problem with mix. Am I XXX? Well, turns out, virtual DJ, since like version 2 or something, has had automatic beat detection, which means it detects the tempo of your song and the like quarter note, like it detects the beat, the tempo, the 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, that whole deal. I don't know what you even call that. Anyway, so nothing else does. Not Serato, not Tractor, not Record Box. Well, Record Box might have an actual check. I don't really care that much about Record Box. I'm just including it in my mentioning so that nobody bitches at me like, you forgot Record Box. Anyway, mix doesn't. I have to manually set beat grids, and I haven't done that for any of the tracks. So when I went through today, before I did my practice set, I set all the beat grids and added like 3 or 4 cue points to every track. Big fucking difference! Imagine that. Ugh. Fucking idiot. So now I have to go through my whole music library, and I have to set beat grids for everything. And I know every tractor user is looking at me like, seriously, bitch? Seriously, you complaining about this? Seriously? But yes, I'm complaining about it. I don't have enough time on my tiny musician paws to take care of all of these problems all at once, and then software, and the studio, and the train wreck, and... Okay, that's enough melodrama for one episode. Anyway, so I kind of have hit a stalemate. So, nothing is selling on eBay. Now, I know you're like, why do we care about eBay? Well, because eBay is awesome, for one thing. And for two things, that I... So I don't actually have a copy of Ableton. I was borrowing on someone else's computer. Someone else's computer who I cannot borrow anymore, obviously. So I no longer have Ableton. I do have Complete 11 now, because I spent $100 to upgrade it with the summer sale from 8 to 11. Woot! Native Instruments, woohoo! So I have Complete 11, so I have all of those plugins, but I have no DAW, because DAWs are expensive. I didn't buy myself Complete 8, in case you couldn't tell. Anyway, and so I kind of have no idea what the hell I'm going to do. So what I've been trying to sell, like, gear that I didn't need, like I sold a whole bunch of my guitar pedals, because I did have a whole huge pedal board of like two of every kind, I swear to God. Like three different delays and a wah and like four different distortions, yeah. Anyway, I had a lot of pedals. Now I only have two. Some other miscellaneous equipment so that I could upgrade the equipment that I have and buy myself a copy of Ableton. And I can't do that if nothing is selling on eBay. So, yeah! So, I tried to, like, lower some prices, or, like, change things around, like, rename the options so they pop up in different searches. And nothing is working. I did get a couple more watches on a couple of the MIDI controllers I have for sale, but... If I sell both of them, I'll be able to get a copy of Ableton, which would be awesome. At least I think I'll be able to get a copy. I might have spent like $20 or $30, like, of my money that I didn't make from selling things. Water is good. So, yeah, so that's frustrating, because I just have to sit here and wait, and I'm like, I want to work on music now! Ow, shit. Don't stomp your foot on concrete floors. Ow, what? That hurts. So yeah, I'm kind of just sitting in my studio, like, you guys can't see me twiddling with them. Like, what the hell do I do with myself? So I've just been DJing, mixing, practicing, getting more acquainted with my library and stuff, trying to be a better DJ and not a lazy DJ. Speaking of being a lazy DJ, so I have a really funny story to tell you that's going to make all of you cringe. Okay? You ready? You don't like cringy? Go watch something else on my channel. Okay? We're just kidding. Anyways. Anyway. So, I've been DJing since 2011, right? So, well, October 2011. So, almost 6 years. Just as long as I've been producing. Well, like, a week longer than I've been producing. But, I have never mixed with headphones. Not even once. I know, now, I only recently learned this in like the last 2 weeks, what Q was and what the Q and mix control was on my controller. Yeah, I didn't know that. I feel like someone who didn't know what sidechaining was until they were already like playing EDC festivals and shit. Like, I feel way behind the game. So, I am now trying to like fandangle an output system for my controller, because I would ideally like to use this as my sound card at gigs. So I can plug headphones straight in here, mic straight in here, and output straight at the back. Because that would be awesome, right? Well, I have to like fandangle some way to use speakers with this. Because this is a stereo output. Even on the, well, yeah, it's a stereo output. I mean, I guess I could just do one channel, but. So I have to like fandangle a way to practice with that way. And while I have not actually set up my software to do with headphones, I'm gonna do that. Right now, for my gig, I'm going to go straight from an 8th inch to well, probably stereo or mono. I don't even know. Stereo or mono? I don't even know. I'm so funny. Or maybe I just like to rhyme. I don't know. We'll talk about it some other time. Hey! Oh, God. So, yeah. Yeah. I didn't know that. And I feel really dumb. Like, I don't know what the hell I thought Q select button was for. Or what the Q mix control was for. Or that's volume actually, but. Fucking. I don't know, dude. I'm also cursing a lot more in these videos. I might have to chop that out. We'll see. Yeah, so. I lost my day job, my other day job. Because I think I lost it. I don't even know. She wasn't very clear with me. So I now have to fucking find another day job. And there's like one or two places in town that are hiring, but it's just bottom of the barrel kind of places, and I'm just not looking forward to it. I really don't want to do it at all, like even a little, but it's all worth it to take care of my family and to keep going with music, so 100% worth it every time, every shitty job I'll ever have, even if that's forever, because I don't have a backup plan, because I'm an idiot, you know, so be it. Music, so worth it. So worth it. Every time. So yeah. What else is going on in life? Just kind of having some. I've been really down today. Just kind of having a down, like a bad day. Like I just felt like crap. Like nothing's any worse than it was like yesterday or the day before, but. Still feel like junk. I don't know. Just a bad day today. This has actually made me feel a lot better, so thanks, guys. Fun fact, I actually wink at you guys with my good eye, so when I wink, I can't see anything, because I'm completely blind in the sun. Woo! Cataracts! Anyway, so I think that about wraps up this one. I just don't have that much more to talk about. You guys should definitely check out my other series, Crate Digging with Rachel G, where I take a favorite from my from the back of my guitar. Sorry, I was gonna be like all sly and we've got a record, but okay. Where I take a favorite from my record collection and I share it with you. Not a famous favorite, so not something that you know already, but something that's a little obscure, something you might not have heard before. And I share it with you, and I go into a little bit of detail about like its history and maybe the history of the artist or the label. I just did one with a record from 2000 by a Canadian label Fortress Recordings. Illfingas and True Crime Killing Floors. And it was a really like cheesy setup with a Sharpie and a notebook, which is exactly what it's going to be the next time on Monday. That's every Monday, and we're gonna do 12 of those, and we're gonna see how it goes and see how you guys like it. And I might do like a second season where I go through the CDs or something. That would be really cool, right? Anyway, so you guys should definitely check that out and like if you haven't. So subscribe if you haven't, so you can catch the next one. And I'll catch you later. I've been Label. So, subscribe if you haven't so you can catch the next one, and I'll catch you later. And now we're going to show you the lighting, because it's funny. And we'll just cut out all the shit. Check that shit out. Isn't that hilarious? Fucking pop filter. This is where you guys sit. I'll catch you guys next time.